Hello, this is Vance, and this is Monday, August the 18th, 2014. These are the CL trades for today using the Slohan method for price action. It was a down day today, a range day today. It started out looking like we were going to have a retracement back to the where we were yesterday or on Friday. It didn't quite make it that far, but certainly in the overnight, I had mentioned this. I came in here, I had the update just prior to 9 o'clock. I mentioned that there's a downtrend here. It was a pretty steep channel. We had a bounce back up here, pulled back. And I was thinking there could either be a reversal back to where the overnight high was, given that we've had this strong move up on Friday. But also the other equal factor is the fact that we could have a continuation moving it down here. And that turned out really to be what the case was. The other thing I mentioned was the fact that because today's a split contract, I mean, there's more and more volume going over to October contract, and I will be switching over tonight to be trading the October contract tomorrow. There wasn't a lot of volume, and when you have split contract trading like this, it's really, really important to recognize the fact that the movements won't be as dramatic, and so you have to exercise more patience because things are moved sideways a little bit more, generally speaking, or prices will appear to be stuck more in a rut than they are during any other time, except perhaps before the Department of Energy report or the FOMC or something like that, like a very large news-driven event. But in this particular case, when price did move down there, I was looking for kind of a continuation of price to continue down. Did initially. So here's a place to get in. I mean, this is a few minutes after the open. There was rejection here. You can see that price went up here the first time, failed, went up the second time, failed, went up a third time. And so this is a reasonable place to take a trade. We're at the EMA still. We've had rejection at this area. We had a close down here. It's really a second entry short. Oh, this one's first entry, comes up, pulls back. It's really like a second entry. I mean, the real second entry is right here, but that's at the bottom of the channel. So whether you take it or not, you're looking for another measured move. Down here, if it breaks and holds this area, which in fact did, it did pull back, gave you another opportunity to get in here. I mean, it's a fairly strong bar, but not a lot of room. So I marked this one in green as well, but eventually it did work its way out. Then we have the pullback. Pulls back here, it pulls back right to the EMA or right to the this trend channel, and then a strong bar to sell with. Now, this is a doji. They're both dojis. Why would I mark a sell on this? Well, it's really not about the individual bar. It's where you can put your stop. So if you can limit in on this, that's why it's green, limit in near this resistance of this particular channel. I mean, you could have limited it up here too. I'm not saying that you couldn't have. You would have held through these two dojis, and whether or not you hold in, if you got in at this area, it would have probably put you into the trade at 96.41. And if you were to get in there and hold through this, and even if you didn't buy until this particular bar here, it didn't take much time for it to work out. So here it is at 96.21, 1021, down to here is 10.39. So it only took somewhere in the neighborhood of 18 minutes to get your first contracts off. But when price gets to this level, you can see it starts double bottoming, capitulates, and starts moving sideways. Now, when you see prices moving sideways in a trend like this, depending on how long it stays for, 30 to 40 minutes is long enough. 30 to 40 minutes is long enough for price to be in a trend for it to move in the other direction. So if we look at it from the perspective of when did it actually start going into this really tight trading range? Well, I say that the time it actually started moving through this trading range is right around, I would say 9:30, just before the equity open. Price traded up a couple times, traded down, hit a wall, down at 95.87, we got as low as 95.81, but the high in this channel has got to be right where the most touches are. Let's put it right here. Yeah, right there. 96.16. So if you look at the $96 mark, price typically was rotating around that area. So it looks like support here. Now, there wasn't anything much in here. It was capitulation. Price is moving up. This looks like a potential here. No, it didn't work out. And then you got these long stems up here. Price attempted to go up a couple times. First time failed. Second time, immediate failure. And if we test this area at the bottom, now if you're watching the chart, it was very slowly moving up here. And then this move took all of about 10 minutes removed from this area down to here. Then we have a turnaround, double bottoms, pulls back again, another turnaround, pulls back again, another turnaround. So you have all these inside bars here. It's evident that price can't go any lower at this juncture. And if you limit in to put your stop below this particular candle, I think it was the reasonable activity to do. So you limit in on this chart. But even if you didn't limit in, even if you got on the signal bar, right at this level, you see that it never came back. It didn't take out your stop. Gave you some heat, but it didn't take out your stop. And it ripped up to this area, ripped up to right 96.71. Well, then we had this turnaround right here. Now, markets always oversell. And unless it was some compelling evidence, it's needless to say, you're probably looking at coming back at some point in time. Now, you see this top of the double tops here, we have this first pullback. You'd like to see a new low, but this is the end of the day. This is like 16 minutes after 2 o'clock. Whether it's going to stick or not, that's one to be seen. And the top here really is very coincides with this hesitation that we had just where the overnight open was, where the open was as far as the bell, the pit open. So that's something else to keep in mind. You can see it's very close to that, and then sold off from there. So all in all, kind of a range day, maybe a little difficult for some of these trades. I mean, you had to see that this was a downtrend, and you know, like every reason to go short here. This is sideways. Now, this particular trade is a reason to go short, because you're expecting to actually fail out this bottom and hopefully go a little bit longer, but that wasn't the case. And then you got your 15 ticks out. But in this area, this particular area, from here to here, and from this area back up to here, on a lower time frame or a higher time frame, those bars would compress. And you would see one red bar and one green bar right across here, because price broke up and out of this area. So when it broke up, it went to target, and the target up here was 96.72. Logic target would probably be around this area, 96.64. So this is where you can have your target. We have a bit of a pullback, and now it's off to the races again. You know, first pullback, second pullback. It depends on what's going to happen over the overnight. We'll make a decision about what I'm going to do next. Anyway, this is it for the trades for today. I mean, maybe one thing, I'll bring out the no, I won't do that today. I switched over the contract for the daily, so there'll be a little bit of discrepancy there. But yeah, you can see that this was really a range day. I mean, price traded down, traded back up in the range, and meeting the resistance right at the 96.67. But as I said, this contract will be changed tomorrow. I'm going to be trading the October contract instead. So like always, if there are any questions, please let me know. And I'll say bye for now.